It was fun for me to get to meet the family, just to, you know, we didn't spend a lot of time with them, and they came in the middle of a scene where we were freezing cold, but digging in the ground, and Chad and I were, you know, running around having a good time. Abigail was yelling at us in character. So we had some opportunity to go over and talk to them during that scene.
They told us about their story. I mean, it was a little different from the script, but they told us all about what happened and that they lived in Georgia and all the experiences, and she never saw Mr. Gordy again, but that they kept on having paranormal activity things happen to them. And it was a really touching story, actually.
It's way out in the pantry, and there's lots of room for you to play.
You need help?
I can do it.
Joyce is really a free spirit, and I think that I was raised in a family that was very regimented. I was an athlete, so everything had to be very, very strict and planned. And you know, as I got older, I tried desperately to be more free-spirited and more kind of fly by the seat of my pants and spontaneous. And I think that I'm getting closer to Joyce without going to the extreme of Joyce. So I do have some similarities to her. I think that she's really, really outgoing and fun, and I'd like to think that, you know, that's somebody that I try to be.
It was pretty cool, and at the end of the movie, you also see a picture of Heidi when she was littler, and that was really cool because she had brown hair, but she had my little curls, and she kind of had the same face shape. So I think we're pretty similar.
They were just lovely people. You know, they felt so honored by the fact that we were actually doing this and that we each had a little piece in telling their story, and it was just such a really nice thing to be able to meet them and be able to be a part of something that in their minds gave their story validation.
It's coming for me.
I told you something bad happened here.